I look forward to seeing many of you in Bangkok soon, where we will enter the final 15 days of negotiations before Copenhagen. After selective progress at the last informal meeting in Bonn, I said that if we continued at that rate, we would not make it, that we would be unable to deliver the robust agreement the world needs to avoid dangerous climate change. But a month can make a big difference. With so little time left, I have a real sense that the international community is gearing up to get the job done in Copenhagen. September has brought a string of news which brings us ever closer to the commitments and the concrete pledges we need to untie the knots which are left in the negotiations. For example, the Japanese government's significantly higher new pledge to reduce emissions by 25% over 1990 levels, initial proposals for financial support from the European Commission that include concrete numbers, China's stated position that it has a very serious desire for an agreement, all of these help to light more clearly the path before us. As always, we know the essential components of the political agreement which Copenhagen must deliver. First, ambitious and binding emission cuts by industrialized countries. Second, further efforts to restrain emissions growth by developing countries. Third, stable and predictable finance and technology support to help the developing world adapt and mitigate, with a large down payment to kickstart action immediately. And finally, a system which manages it in a way that gives all an equal voice. I'm confident that the climate change summit, which the UN Secretary General has convened in New York on September the 22nd, will produce strong confirmation of this emerging political will to get the job done in Copenhagen. The negotiations can therefore be focused and realistic. There are around 280 pages of negotiating text on the table to cut down to size. There is no doubt that we need a final push to reach a higher ambition to meet the essential political objectives. But it is only realistic to say that the negotiations will not resolve every small detail on every issue under consideration. All sides must trust that a strong political agreement will be the foundation on which countries will then confidently and quickly build the details of the systems, markets, and mechanisms that will drive decisive action against climate change. A strong agreement in Copenhagen to tackle climate change will keep humanity in control of its destiny. Lose that opportunity now, and we will shortly lose it forever. We are too close to an agreement now to fail at the last gate. Thank you.